What's up, guys? I'm Pete from the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, and we're a channel dedicated to helping you grow your Twitch or YouTube gaming channels so you can make a profession out of your gaming passion. Today, we're going to be talking about how you can remove background noise from your voiceovers. Now, if you have background noise in your audio recordings already, because you live on a busy street where there's a lot of car noise going past, or maybe you have to have a fan on in your room, or maybe you just have a beast computer that has a really loud fan, and that's, you can always hear that in your audio recordings. Today I'm going to be teaching you how, with free software, you can remove that background noise so you can just hear the crystal clear voice. Now, you may be thinking that high quality audio doesn't really matter as long as your video looks good, but actually I find the opposite is true. If you go and have a look at your favorite streamers or YouTube channels, I guarantee that they'll probably have on par audio quality with their video quality, if not higher. So what I'll be covering in this video is I am going to turn on some of the fans that I have in my room, create a kind of noisy environment and take an audio recording. Then I'm going to jump onto the computer and I'm going to show you in Audacity how I can remove that background noise. So it'll be a live example as to how I've removed the noisy fans from my recording so that you can do the same at home. I've now turned the fans on, so hopefully you can hear there's quite a lot of background noise going on. Not an ideal recording environment, but something worthwhile for the tutorial. So I'm just going to create a quick voice clip that I'm going to use to then remove the background audio. Hi, I'm Pete from the Gaming Careers YouTube channel. Why not subscribe? Now, before we jump into Audacity and look at the noise reduction process, I would just give you four tips on how to record higher quality audio in general. First one is try and remove as much noise as you can before even recording your audio. So if you can turn fans off or close windows, that's really going to help, because the less noise you have, the less noise reduction you need to do. The second tip is all about the mic positioning from your face. I know a lot of YouTubers use the Blue Yeti or the Blue Snowball, and you want to try and position that about 6 to 12 inches from your face. Not directly in front, you don't want to be speaking into it like this. You want to be about 6 to 12 inches away. My third tip would be to invest in a cheap pop filter. A pop filter basically just removes some of the pop noises that you create when you say your P's and your T's and removes them from the microphone. It acts as like a filter in between your mouth and the microphone. They're really cheap. You can pick them up on Amazon pretty cheaply, or you can always just use a sock, as it does just as good a job. Finally, my fourth tip is to make sure that your audio levels within whichever program you're recording your audio with are set correctly. If this is in your camera settings or in something like Audacity, you want to be aiming for between minus 12 and minus 6 dB for when you're recording your audio. Then you can always boost this if you need to in post-production. Now, the first thing that you're going to want to do is download and install Audacity. I've put a link in the description below to take you to the website, and there are versions for PC and for Mac, so it doesn't matter what operating system you're running. The installation process is actually pretty basic, so I'm not going to cover that here. Just install it as you do with any other program. So the next thing we want to do is to open up our audio file that we're going to be editing. You can, of course, use Audacity to record your voiceovers, and I'd recommend doing so. So if you're just looking to record and then edit your audio afterwards, then you just hit the record button. But I'm going to be opening up my example that I recorded earlier. The next thing we want to do is just to zoom in on the timeline. So you can select the zoom tool here and try and find a point in the video where you weren't talking and it's just the background noise that's occurring. Once you found a section that has just background noise and none of your voice over the top, you want to select that section. Next, go up to Effect, down to Noise Reduction, and then a new window will pop up. You just want to click Get Noise Profile. And what that's going to do is it's going to take the section that you just highlighted and set that as the noise profile. Now select all of the audio. You can do that by pressing Control A. Go back up to Effect, Noise Reduction. And then if you copy my settings here, you can play around with these if it's not quite removing all of the background audio, but I find my settings are a pretty good starting point, and then you can just press OK. Now, what this has done is it has taken the noise profile that you set and basically subtracted that from the full recording. It does lower the quality of your voice a tiny bit, but hopefully if you've set a good noise profile, this should be pretty negligible. Let's now listen back to what it's been able to do in terms of noise reduction. Hi, I'm Pete from the Gaming Careers YouTube channel. Why not subscribe? Hi, I'm Pete from the Gaming Careers YouTube channel. Why not subscribe? I'm pretty satisfied with that, so we'll go ahead and export the audio. We just go up to File, Export Audio, and save the file as a WAV. I would then go back into your editing suite of choice. For me, that's Premiere Pro, and import the new WAV into your project and drag it down to a new timeline. As you can see, it matches up perfectly because it's the exact same length. And then we can mute the original audio track, which has the noisy background audio. And that is pretty much it. Hopefully you guys have had good results with that and been able to reduce the noise in the background of your recordings or your voiceovers. If you've watched all the way to this point in the video and you found the video helpful, please do give it a thumbs up. That really does help us out. And also have a look around at the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, where we're starting to really build up a good amount of videos helping you guys create better videos for YouTube and better live streams for Twitch. Until next time, guys, peace.